In this screencast, we're going to look at an example of an isothermal mixing process and use an enthalpy concentration diagram for H2SO4. We have 2 pounds of pure water at 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's mixed isothermally with 1 pound of 68% H2SO4 solution. That's also at 100 Fahrenheit. We want to find the heat that's released upon mixing. So when we say it's being mixed isothermally, we know that the inputs are at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Isothermally means constant temperature, so the outlet is also at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Mixing of H2SO4 with water is an exothermic process. So if we're keeping the temperature constant, that means heat is released. So we're trying to find how much heat's released for mixing this particular process. So we'll need an energy balance, but before we get there, we need to find the mass and concentration for the mixture. And for that, we can use mass balances. We know that mass is conserved, and if there's no accumulation in the mixing unit, we know the mass balances will have the form of in is equal to out. We can use a total mass balance to figure out the total mass of the mixture. The mass going into the mixing unit is 2 pounds plus 1 pound, so m out must be equal to 3 pounds. Now we can use an H2SO4 balance or a water balance to find the concentration. I'll use H2SO4. The mass fraction of the H2SO4 stream entering the mixing unit is 0.6, and we multiply that by the total mass, which is 1 pound. That has to be equal to the mass fraction of the mixture, which has a composition variable of x, times the total mass, which we just calculated was 3 pounds. So in this case, the mass fraction of H2SO4 of the mixture is equal to 0.2. So let's use these values to set up an energy balance that's going to allow us to calculate the heat that's released upon mixing. I've redrawn the flowchart to account for the variables that we just calculated. And if we want to calculate the heat that's released, we need an energy balance. In this case, our energy balance is Q is equal to delta H, which is our change in enthalpy. So we can rewrite the change in enthalpy as the outlet enthalpy minus the inlet enthalpy. And in each case, the total enthalpy is related to the amount of material that we have in each stream. So we can rewrite our energy balance in terms of the masses for each stream as well as their specific enthalpy, where specific enthalpy is on a per unit mass basis. I've assigned a specific enthalpy variable for each stream, which we can use to rewrite the energy balance. So we have Q is equal to, on the outlet side, 3 pounds times the specific enthalpy H3, minus 2 pounds times H1, and 1 pound times H2. So the total inlet enthalpy is the sum of the material flow rates times the specific enthalpy of each stream on the inlet side. To find values for the specific enthalpy of each stream, we can look at a concentration diagram since we know both the concentration of each stream as well as the temperature. The diagram that's shown shows the specific enthalpy in units of BTUs per pound of solution as a function of the mass fraction of H2SO4. So the specific enthalpy is shown as a function of concentration at a variety of temperatures ranging from 32 degrees Fahrenheit to 200. So we have three specific enthalpies that we need to find for the three streams in our process. The first stream is pure water. So the mass fraction of H2SO4 is equal to zero, and we know the temperature is 100. So it's somewhere on the 100 degree isotherm. If we trace that back up to x is equal to zero, we can get the specific enthalpy. So it's slightly less than 70 BTUs per pound, so I'll use a value of 68. In our second stream, the mass fraction of H2SO4 was 0.6. That stream was also at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So if we trace the 100 degree isotherm the other direction to x is equal to 0.6, we can get the specific enthalpy here. So at x is equal to 0.6, it's slightly above negative 110 BTUs per pound, so I'll use a value of negative 108. For our mixture on the outlet side, we know that the mixture has a mass fraction of H2SO4 of 0.2, which we calculated from the mass balance. Because it's an isothermal mixing process, we also know that the temperature is staying constant at 100 degrees. So if we follow the 100 degree isotherm to x is equal to 0.2, or 20 weight percent H2SO4, we can find the specific enthalpy. And that is represented by this point on the enthalpy diagram. So we know that the specific enthalpy is somewhere between 0 and negative 10, I'm going to use a value for negative 6 BTUs per pound. With the specific enthalpy of each stream known from the diagram, we can go back to our energy balance to solve for the heat that's released. All right, going back to our energy balance, we know that the heat that's released is equal to the change in total enthalpy. And the total enthalpy of each stream is the product of the mass times the specific enthalpy, which we just determined from the enthalpy diagram. So plugging those values into our energy balance, we find that the heat that is released is equal to negative 46 BTUs. So here the negative indicates an exothermic process, so 46 BTUs of heat is being released.